Chapter 18, How Ozma Looked Into the Magic Picture. Princess Ozma was a very busy little ruler, for she looked carefully after the comfort and welfare of her people, and tried to make them happy. If any quarrels arose, she decided them justly. If anyone needed counsel or advice, she was ready and willing to listen to them. For a day or two after Dorothy and her companions had started on their trip, Ozma was occupied with the affairs of her kingdom. Then she began to think of some manner of occupation for Uncle Henry and Aunt Em that would be light and easy and yet give the old people something to do. She soon decided to make Uncle Henry the keeper of the jewels, for someone really was needed to count and look after the bins and barrels of emeralds, diamonds, rubies, and other precious stones that were in the royal storehouses. That would keep Uncle Henry busy enough, but it was harder to find something for Aunt Em to do. The palace was full of servants, so there was no detail of housework that Aunt Em could look after. While Ozma sat in her pretty room engaged in thought, she happened to glance at her magic picture. This was one of the most important treasures in all the Land of Oz. It was a large picture set in a beautiful gold frame, and it hung in a prominent place upon a wall of Ozma's private room. Usually this picture seemed merely a country scene, but whenever Ozma looked at it and wished to know what any of her friends or acquaintances were doing, the magic of this wonderful picture was straightway disclosed, for the country scene would gradually fade away, and in its place would appear the likeness of the person or persons Ozma might wish to see, surrounded by the actual scenes in which they were then placed. In this way, the princess could view any part of the world she wished, and watch the actions of anyone in whom she was interested. Ozma had often seen Dorothy in her Kansas home by this means, and now, having a little leisure, she expressed a desire to see her little friend again. It was while the travelers were at Fuddlecumjig, and Ozma laughed merrily as she watched in the picture her friends trying to match the pieces of Grandmother Knit. "They seem happy and are doubtless having a good time," the girl ruler said to herself. And then she began to think of the many adventures she had herself encountered with Dorothy. The images of her friends now faded from the magic picture, and the old landscape slowly reappeared. Ozma was thinking of the time when Dorothy and her army, she marched to the Gnome King's underground cavern, beyond the Land of Ev, and forced the old monarch to liberate his captives, who belonged to the royal family of Ev. That was the time when the Scarecrow nearly frightened the Gnome King into fits by throwing one of Billina's eggs at him, and Dorothy had captured King Roquat's magic belt and brought it away with her to the Land of Oz. The pretty princess smiled at the recollection of this adventure, and then she wondered what had become of the Gnome King since then. Merely because she was curious and had nothing better to do, Ozma glanced at the magic picture and wished to see in it the King of the Gnomes. Roquat the Red went every day into his tunnel to see how the work was getting along and to hurry his workmen as much as possible. He was there now, and Ozma saw him plainly in the magic picture. She saw the underground tunnel reaching far underneath the deadly desert, which separated the Land of Oz from the mountains beneath which the Gnome King had his extensive caverns. She saw that the tunnel was being made in the direction of the Emerald City, and knew at once it was being dug so that the army of gnomes could march through it and attack her own beautiful and peaceful country. "I suspect King Roquat is plotting revenge against us," she said musingly, "and thinks he can surprise us and make us his captives and slaves. How sad it is that anyone can have such wicked thoughts. But I must not blame King Roquat too severely, for he is a gnome and his nature is not so gentle as my own." Then she dismissed from her mind further the thought of the tunnel for that time, and began to wonder if Aunt Em would not be happy as royal mender of the stockings of the ruler of Oz. Ozma wore few holes in her stockings, still they sometimes needed mending. Aunt Em ought to be able to do that very nicely. Next day, the princess watched the tunnel again in her magic picture, and every day afterwards she devoted a few minutes to inspecting the work. It was not especially interesting, but she felt that it was her duty. Slowly but surely, the big arched hole crept through the rocks underneath the deadly desert, and day by day it grew nearer and nearer to the Emerald City.